real numbers exercise 1.4 basics. So to solve exercise 1.4, the basics we need are, we should know what is terminating decimal expansion and what is non-terminating decimal expansion. Okay, we have to know what these two terms are. Now let us take the example 6 by 15. Let's divide the number. Now it will not go, so we'll take point and we'll make it as 0, 15, 4, 60. Here, see, the coefficient is decimal, but it is terminating. When we can say it is terminating? When we get the remainder as 0, even the coefficient is decimal, even though the coefficient is decimal, then we can say that the denominator is, then we can say that it is terminating decimal. See, here the coefficient is decimal, but we got the remainder as 0. So it is called as terminating decimal expansion. Suppose there will be some case like in this type of situation, we'll not get the remainder as 0. We'll get something as 1, 2, 3, 4 or 1, 2, 3, 4. Here, it will be repeating in some cases. 1, 2, 3, 4, again it will repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4, again it will repeat. But we will not get the remainder as 0. That type of decimal is called as non-terminating decimal expansion. If we get the coefficient as this type of number, then it is called as non-terminating decimal expansion. In this, we will not get the remainder as 0. And there will be some numbers. Here, one more point is that if we get the decimal number as non-terminating and it is repeating, then we can say that it is a rational number. Okay, this is what the difference between terminating and non-terminating. Now let's check how to check whether the given number is terminating or non-terminating. Let us take an example. Suppose if they have given this number and asked us to find whether the given number is terminating decimal expansion or non-terminating decimal expansion. Suppose if the denominator is of the form (2m) or 5m or 2m into 5m or 5m into 2n. This is 2n. So if the denominator is of any of this form, that is 2m or 5m or 2n into 5m or 5m into 2n, anything, If it satisfies any of this condition, then we can say that the given number is terminating decimal expansion. Let's do it. Now we will convert this by prime factor number, prime factorization. Since it is odd number, it will not go in the table of 3, it will go in the table of 5. Now we will get 625. Again it will go in the table of 5. 125, again 5. 25, again 5. Now if 5 is a prime factor, we'll stop it here. Now 3125 can be written as 5 into 5 into 5 into 5 into 5. So 3125 can be written as 5 power of 4. See, here the denominator is of the form 5 power m. It satisfies the condition 5 power m. So we can say that the given number is terminating decimal expansion. Now let's see the second case. (29/343). Now let's take the denominator and do prime factorization. Now it will go in the table of 7, 749. Again it will go in the table of 7, 7, 7. Now denominator can be written in the form 7 into 7 into 7. That is 7³. Here the denominator is neither of the form 2 power m or 5 power m or 2 power m n into 5 power m or 5 power n into 2 power m. So we can say that it is non-terminating decimal expansion. Now let's see another example. That is 129/2² (5)/7, (7)/5. Now here we can see that the denominator is 2² (5)/7, (7)/5. Though we can see that it is, these two are of the form 2 power n, 5 power m. But we have an extra number here. So we can't say that it is of the form 2 power m into 5 power n. So it is a non-terminating decimal expansion, because it is of the form, it is not of the form 2 power m, 5 power n. But we have 2 power m, 5 power n with other number. So we can say that this is non-terminating decimal expansion and repeating, because it contains 2 power n and 5 power m, but it contains with another number. So we should tell non-terminating decimal expansion and repeating. We should not tell only non-terminating decimal expansion. We should say non-terminating decimal expansion and repeating.